Good morning, everybody. It's great to be here. You've already heard some of the amazing things going on the cell engineering platform at Ginkgo. We're going to hear tons more today. But I'm also excited to have the opportunity to share a bit about what we're doing around building the capabilities and technologies to ensure we also have a safe and secure future with biology. It's something we care very deeply about here at Ginkgo. I'm going to talk today actually about the products that we are partnering with governments to bring to the world in that capacity. But I wanted to start, because though I got some Army guys in the front, probably pay more attention to this. Not everybody thinks about this topic every day. So I wanted to give you like the two big framing things for how we think about what we're building. First, we live in an age of pandemics. And that's not just like a tagline, right? Actually, and I'd encourage you to read this report led by Nita Madhav, our head of epidemiological analytics at Ginkgo. It really is a numbers game. And the basic kind of like takeaway from the report, not to simplify it too much, is we have a lot of airports, we have a lot of people, we travel a lot, and we are encroaching upon natural lands more and more. There's likely to be, within the next 25 years, I think about the careers that we have building this company, another event on the order of SARS-CoV-2. We should be really thoughtful about that. It's really about how we live as humans. But I think the one that we talk less about, because it's scary, that we have to be clear-eyed about, is what Jason alluded to, is that there are also human-made threats. Every time in human history when we have taken a base science, whether that be chemistry or physics, and turn it into an engineerable discipline, humans have chosen to use those technologies in new and creative ways in human conflict. We have to do everything we possibly can to stop that in this era, but we also have to be clear-eyed that that is a risk. So those two big things are the things we think about when we think about the technologies we need to build. Like, the silver lining, though, is that governments are thinking about this, right? And so I really love this quote. It's from the U.S. National Biodefense Strategy in 2022. We seek to create a world free from catastrophic biological incidents. That's a pretty inspirational and aspirational statement. It's going to take incredible technology creation to do so. And the way to think about what needs to be built is essentially you need to do massive scale detection, always on, everywhere, at all times. You need to do characterization, prioritization, you need to figure out if those things are threats, and then you need to be able to mitigate them. And so when we think about a framework for the technologies that governments and companies need to build, that's how we think about it. So at Ginkgo Biosecurity, which we're officially announcing kind of this rebrand today, really what that is about is taking the power of the Ginkgo platform, the network of companies and people that engage with us, and putting those all towards that detect, characterize, prioritize, decide, and respond framework. So I'll give you like a little bit of the next piece of what those actually products and technologies feel like. Most of those folks that would know our efforts here would know us as Concentric by Ginkgo. This was our outbreak detection product. At the height of the pandemic, we served over 5,000 schools across the country. And it became like a really trusted product for monitoring classrooms where communities and principals and teachers and families we're able to apply modern biotech to keep kids in educational settings. If we are successful in the rest of what we do, obviously we hope never have to use this product again, but it is ready to go in the case we need to. The next category here is our detect product called Ginkgo Canopy. This is really the way to think about this is radar for biology. We work with countries around the world, primarily focused on monitoring their airports. Over the last 3 years, this has been like very exciting for our team to see this scale from nothing, from an idea that we partnered with CDC, and Dr. Cindy Friedman is in the room, and she'll speak on the panel later, to now working in 12 international airports. We have panels monitoring over 60 pathogens in countries from Ukraine to Qatar to Rwanda. This is a massively scaled program, and we have a great pipeline of other countries that are interested in deploying Ginkgo Canopy, radar for biology, detection at their airports. This is a little bit of an image of what that means. What is the product? It turns the environment into a high fidelity data asset. This is a picture from Rwanda, a device that's a proprietary device where we collect wastewater off of the airplanes, move them directly onto sequencers, and turn that into a data set that can be used for early warning and other detection capabilities. What's exciting is if you get enough countries involved in building Ginkgo Canopy in their own airports, you start to be able to build a new data set of how infectious disease in real time flows around the world. And so this is an example of the last year and a half of COVID variants from our different programs, tracking, again, remember back to natural pandemics, the airports, tracking over human activity. How do pathogens move in correspondence with humans? But Ginkgo Canopy doesn't just have to be airports. If you think about radar configurations, we're working with our most innovative customers in different countries to say, how can you adapt and mold this for other areas of high bio risk? Hospitals, borders, right? Animal production farms. These are areas where threats can emerge that if you want to stop something, you need to find them immediately and understand what it is. Our second primary product that we're making available is essentially the so what product, the decision product. This is called Ginkgo Horizon. It seeks to answer the actual questions. Once you've done detect, okay, what is this threat? And how bad is it? So some of you might remember back last fall, there was this like mystery pneumonia that was putting kids in hospitals in Northeast China, right? It was all headline news and kind of like nobody knew exactly what was going on. Is this a new pandemic? Is this gonna impact kids? Or is this just because China just has opened and there's a need to recreate immunity? Nobody really knew. Those are the kind of questions that we need to be able to answer quickly for national security decision makers, for public health decision makers. The other piece, like for example, for our national security customers, we're able to layer in things like our program called ENDAR, which is a tool, a bioinformatics tool, that allows us to do genetic engineering detection in samples. Is this new sample something that has been engineered, or is it natural? That's the kind of idea of get to insight, get to so what, so you can make better decisions. What Horizon rests on are two primary data assets. One, when appropriate and authorized by the countries we partner with, we can make the Ginkgo Canopy data feeds available. That's a really powerful tool of molecular detection from collection at airports and other locations that we can make available on this platform. The other side of it is all the other important information, essentially digital monitoring. What is happening on the Ministry of Health's website in X country? Did they just post an alert? Should we be tuning our analysis to a new location? Today for our customers, this is available in a set of data feeds focused on those questions, but also we're launching and building this into a set of interactive platforms to increase the pace of decision making. You want it to do detection and then rapid decision making if you're meant to close the gap on biothreat reduction. Lastly, if you build this with a mindset like you build cyber, you're constantly improving your capabilities. You can keep deploying new modules into these platforms. So we're very excited in the last few weeks to have announced collaborations with the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, with CDC's Center for Forecasting Analytics, really thinking about next level, next era predictions. So we can go from reaction, oh, there's somebody in a hospital, we must do something about it, to what's going to put people in a hospital and how do we mitigate it. We've got collaborators across the country, across the world. Northeastern is one of our major collaborators. I know folks are in the room today and we really appreciate doing this in collaboration with others. The last thing I'll just close on is like the last piece of this with some of our kind of deepest partnerships globally, we're thinking about how do you take Canopy radar for biology and put it with the decision support in one unified facility that does detection through support for mitigation. And that's what the Center for Unified Biosecurity Excellence is that we announced a couple months ago called CUBE. 1+1 in that sense is meant to be greater than 2. We've launched our first design and build process in Doha called CUBE-D. This is a unique place to do this. We're building it in the Qatar Free Zone right next to Hamad International Airport, which touches about 60% of the world's population within an 8-hour flight. It's a really powerful place to put detection for global biothreat alert. What is it actually? It's a large-scale sequencing, biobanking, bioinformatics, and analytics center, right? It both serves our major programs with Qatar, but what's really unique about it is it gives access to data generation to partners at nodes and other countries around that can't necessarily always be versioning the most cutting-edge bioinformatics analysis, the most cutting-edge data interpretation, environment-to-data type mindset. So I would say in closing for us, if you were going to take those first two threats, natural and man-made, and reduce the risk that they impact our next 25 or 50 years. You have to think about doing detection, characterization, and response in hours or days, not months and years. That has to be the aspiration for what we're doing. And it feels like a big task, but also creating a world free of catastrophic biological incidents is a big task. And so Ginkgo is going to do everything we can to push this forward, but honestly, biotech is a big, big tent, right? It's going to take everybody in this room and beyond this room to do it really effectively. So thanks for the opportunity to give you that. We'll keep giving updates on kind of like what we're building and trying to put in the world going forward. So thank you for your time, and I will turn it over to the chair people and then to Allison and the panel.